Preserving specimen is another issue because by doing this we are violating animal right to live.
There are certain limitations to study the preserved specimens in the museum. It is very difficult to maintain the preserved specimens for a very longer time. They undergo deterioration over the time. We have to employ the curator to maintain them. And once they are deteriorated, it is difficult to purchase as per the guidelines of Government of India.
In practical classroom, the students don't find interest in studying taxonomy of animal biodiversity because of the poor condition of the preserved specimens. Many times, the specific characters of a particular animal is not visible clearly. Students have to study meristic as well as morphometric actor of a particular specimen, but these are not very much clear with the preserved specimen.
Zoology eMuseum.com is dynamic, flexible, knowledgeable and resourceful free online site being developed after collection of digital pictures of various species and specimens from various museums of different colleges and universities in India.
Development of eMuseum holds a key to solve the problems of the students, and with the help of this eMuseum, the students, they have a microscope in hand and they can exactly study the structures and the functions of the specimens, and they are able to correlate these specimens with the biodiversity, which is an integral part of their syllabus.
It provides information about classification, habitat and peculiar features along with research updates of all animals in the world.
The website for eMuseum has been developed by the students by and large. Initially, students were not fully aware how a website has to be developed, what features a website has. So they were asked to conduct a survey and they scanned more than two dozen websites, and they identified features which website must include.
This project was started in May last year only and is in progress still. Actually, this eMuseum is a collection of different databases, different websites and different museums from different colleges all over India, like JNV University Jodhpur, Rajasthan University Jaipur, CCS University Meerut, etc., like Zakir Hussain College of Delhi University only. From this, we are not actually saving the lives of all insects and all animals. We are also making things more easily available.
By creating eMuseum, we are trying to generate awareness and also minimizing killing animals for preserving, as these animals are important in many food chain and food webs and also a part of ecosystem.
This innovative research project has developed a lot of research interest in us. We students find studying taxonomy with traditional museum animal specimens very often less interesting. Some morphological characters are not very much clear. We simply mug up the facts and give the practical exams. Such problem led us to come out with this novel idea of eMuseum for animals listed in our syllabus.
This e-museum is available via social media also, and moreover, this project has developed a lot of inspiration and motivation among the undergraduate students, and many students, they have approached me after knowing about such projects for another similar projects. So this such type of project, innovative project, is very much beneficial for the undergraduate students because they develop research interest among them for a future career in research.
University of Delhi took a great initiative in starting innovation projects in that university. At our college, that is Dyal Singh College, we have got a good number of innovation projects. And one such project was our e-museum, which is being coordinated by our faculty members in Zoology department and Computer Science department. And they are being associated with 10 other students. And they have come out with a good list of specimens, which otherwise would have taken a long time for students to study. Now it would be an easy approach of such students, be it at Delhi University or outside Delhi in different colleges. They will be able to study these specimens through electronic media. And I would wish that such an exercise is taken up by some other teachers and students in years to come, and they replicate this for plants. And since it would be available free to students, it would be a great addition to our knowledge.